all. That my mother's mad. Not just queer in the head, but quite mad. It's true. They're taking her to the loony bin.
You shouldn't talk like that.
Why not? Everyone else will.
What will you do now?
I can look after myself.
Well, if there's anything that I can do...
Just keep your nose out of other people's business, Mr. McDonald.
There's no need to be rude, Miss Pollard. I was merely offering a Christian hand.
I know where it'd be, given half the chance.
I was distressed about your mother, Miss Pollard. I cannot but help feel sorry for you, too.
Mr. McDonald. Sorry. Forgive me.
Certainly, Miss Pollard. Well, hello, Miss Glover. How nice to see you again. We've been playing cricket.
Did you win?
Indeed we did.
Angus scored the winning run.
Good for you, Angus.
We were thinking of having a nice at Camino's Cafe. Would you care to join us?
Why not, Mr. McDonald? I've nothing else to do.
She bumped into me. Well, well. I'm Frankie.
I'm Karen.
You're beautiful. I love beautiful things.
Are you in here?
That's right. Right here.
Who else?
Doreen. What'd you do, Karen?
I stabbed someone. To death.
Always like a challenge. Life, eh? Me too. We'll have a happy time together, Karen. It's up to you, love. You can really enjoy yourself if you put your mind to it.
I'm not like that, Frankie.
You're going to have to be. And anything you don't know, I'll teach you.
Get your hand off me!
Don't say anything you might regret, Karen. We're going to be in here night after night for years and years and years.
Mind me, Lou. I want to sell on my own. I won't share with that animal. Animal, am I?
You stupid girl.
Why are you moving me?
Why, indeed.
You can't move her.
We can do anything we like, Doyle.
I won't let you move her.
The decision's already made.
No! Doreen stays with me.
What's the matter? Scared of getting lonely at nights? Come on, out! Move!
Frankie?
Get up.
You are not dismissed, comrade.
But I must speak with your one.
When I permit it. Come, we will throw your weapons.
Your mother!
Stop that, you are partisanka.
Nadia, what is it? What do they want to do with you?
We are making her partisanka.
A soldier, like Biljana.
No.
If she stays, she fights. Come along.
You can't take my nurse.
She is to be a soldier.
There are men in there who will die without her help.
In an emergency, you call for her.
Besides, she's my woman.
Jovan.
Partisans do not have such liaisons. You may marry or be separate.
Oh. And I will conduct the wedding. That is how we do things here. When I marry Biljana.
Tony, we must find time to discuss our little scheme whilst you're down here.
I'm sorry, Julie, I don't think
the
I'm...
house and track?
I hate stations. I don't want to own the damn things.
Oh, Phil, that's enough.
Well, the girls swear too. Behind your back, Lydia does anyhow.
You beastly little telltale. You're afraid of horses.
You're afraid of sharks.
A horse won't bite your leg off.
It might.
You're ridiculous.
I can swim further than you anyhow. Can't I, Blake Minor?
You have all eaten far too much in this heat. think we'd best go to your rooms and rest till it's time to bathe.
Can I come in?
Of course.
I smuggled it up. I had to celebrate with somebody. I got the job.
Oh, that's wonderful, May.
Yes, I'm a sales assistant with a chance to train as an assistant buyer after 12 months. I could hardly believe it. Oh, we'll need to share your glass.
Oh, it's quite a red-letter day, isn't it?
It's lovely to have somebody to share things with.
Yes, it's nice for me too. Good company, May.
Thanks. You too. Cheers.
Cheers.
Lovely. Your turn.
To the future.
And the manageress, the one who hired me for the job, she looks as if she bathes in starch.
Bit of a terror, is she?
I expect I'll get used to her. I'll have to if I want to stay there.
Well, who knows? One day you might end up being manageress.
That is, if my sense of humour doesn't get the better of me. May I be so bold as to inquire what is going on in here?
Mrs. Craig, we were just having a small celebratory drink. Would you care to join us?
I most certainly would not. Perhaps I have not made myself clear on the subject of alcohol in my establishment. But you see, I just got a job.
No, it was entirely my fault, Mrs. Craig.
No, it wasn't. I just got carried away in my excitement. We were only going to have one glass.
It is the first glass that does the damage. Mr. Carson, this is a respectable establishment. It is one thing for a young lady to be found in a gentleman's room. It is quite another for a young lady to be found drinking with a married man. I'm afraid I don't like it at all. Small wonder Mrs. Carson was so distressed.
Mrs. Carson?
Your wife, Mr. Carson. I sent her up here a moment ago.
My wife.
Would you excuse me, please?
May.
Your choice, sir. I can recommend the haddock.
I think we'll both be having the roast lamb. Thank you, Mrs. Craig.
As you wish. You know how she hates it when you don't take a recommendation.
Well, I'll really be punished tomorrow.
I think she's delighted to be seeing the last of me. I don't do a thing for the decorum of this establishment.
I won't be glad to see the last of you. To new friends and the future.
And to the king.
That material was stuck so fast in the machine we had to cut it out. Madame was furious.
It was such a shame. 26 shillings an ell too. Terribly expensive. What is it?
My wife. Margie, my dear. How nice to see you.
I can see that.
I'd like you to meet Miss Campbell. Miss Campbell, this is my wife.
How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
You're pleased to meet me? You brazen-faced little slut!
Marjorie, for God's sake, control yourself!
Why the hell should I?
Shh.
You expect me to keep quiet when you and your husband made me a laughingstock of the whole world?
I'm sorry, Robert. I'm so sorry.
It's me you should be apologizing to, you little floozy. Do you hear me? I heard you in his room. Don't think I don't know what's going on.
Marjorie.
Mr. Carson, please remove this woman from my dining room immediately.
What kind of a bordello do you think you're running here?
Marjorie, please.
Out. Take this woman, your wife, or whoever she may be, off these premises at once.
You needn't act so hoity-toity with me. Don't think I don't know that my husband is living here with that woman.
Never in all my days.
She doesn't know what she's saying.
And you can pack your bags and go now.
Unused as I am to public speaking, I shall be brief and to the point. The notices of the 1st of September were an attempt to break the men and the union. The men would go out, and the mine owners could employ anyone. Well, yesterday, even the scabs couldn't take any more, and they went on strike until their grievances were heard.
You're a liar! Even if you are Edward Birch, you'll behave yourself or get out, like anyone else.
I think it only fair to warn those noisy shopkeepers and businessmen down the back that we're taking note of anyone who heckles or speaks out of turn. We have formed a Corumburra Miners' Women's Auxiliary,
who have unanimously pledged their support and backing of the men in their struggle for a living wage and better conditions, which is the right of all working people.
Detective Chief Inspector Tiger.
My agent, Molly Baron.
Mrs. Baron.
Is this an official visit? If so, aren't you supposed to work in pairs?
You mean, like oxen?
I do know something about procedure.
I'm off.
You must save your voice, Eleanor. You can use that as a reason not to answer their questions.
Molly, come on. They can't charge her without evidence, and if they had that, they'd have charged her already.
What about your solicitor? Should I fly another one up from London?
Molly, your solicitor's fine. He's very good.
Have another piece of cake, Molly. Why not? Bugger the F plan.
Can I come in, please? Mrs. McKenzie, a few weeks ago, your husband assaulted you, and the police were called. You chose not to press charges. I'd like to discuss that with you, if I may.
I'm sorry, I don't wish to discuss it.
Mrs. McKenzie, your husband committed a crime against you. He threw you out in the street in your nightdress. You were bruised and bleeding. All our experience suggests that he's very likely to do it again. I'd like to ask you to think about your own welfare.
And how do I explain that to an 18-year-old preparing for A-levels? And her 16-year-old sister, who only wants to be a nurse? And the 12-year-old brother whose only worry should be what he's going to take on the next school trip. Oh, sorry, loves. I have to think of my own welfare.
What about theirs?
Why do you think I'm here? When they've gone. When they're safe. Really established. Then I'll go. Then I'll do it. But not before.
They know it happened.
He's a good and caring father. It only happens when they're away. Sometimes I think he just can't bear to be left alone with me anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's not so easy, is it? What would you do if you were in my place?
If he attacks you again, please.
Oh, don't
please.
Worry, don't worry. They'll let you know. My neighbours.
Johnny, Johnny, all we ever hear from you is Johnny!
Marika!
And it's your fault. You allow it. You've always allowed it. Just because he's your best friend and he's old enough to be her father.
Stop it, sir. Kid is it as we
are. Never, that's enough. Stop the apple. How many times do I have to tell you? You speak English in this house, only English, like they teach you in the school.
Nona wants something.
It's a coffee. She wants a coffee.
Tell her to get it. She's the one who wants to stay at home and be an old maid.
America.
It's all right, Baba. I'll fix it.
And tell your boyfriend, turn down that blaster gramophone.
Coffee? What is it?
I forgot my glass.
What are you all lashed up about this time?
Oh, Pat, what are we going to do?
Like that, is it? Same old thing.
If Johnny has done this.
And I wouldn't put it past him. Hold the bag, will you?
Oh, Pat, not so hard. Pat, I'm not Johnny Faberge, you know. Stop it!
Is this place open or closed, do you know?
Oh, I guess it's open. They gave me a cup of coffee when I asked for it.
Mm. It's handy to the hospital.
Look, why don't you knock? I think they're having some trouble in the kitchen. There was a lot of yelling.
Must be an interesting book.
It is. And I'd really like to continue reading it.
Psychosurgery. Well, well, you must be a nurse.
No, I'm a doctor.
A new intern?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I am. And so are you, right?
I'm Craig Rothwell.
Gail Henderson.
Now give me all the money or I'll shoot.
Gentlemen wouldn't be policed by any chance.
Yes. It has to be done.
Many happy returns.
Oh, Frankie, that was terrific. You must have really worked hard last night.
I'm doing good, eh?
You're doing very well.
Yeah, I'm doing well.
Look, shall I read for a bit and you follow? Bob blows out the candles and makes a wish. He wishes for a pony. Even Jip the dog has some cake. There are lots of good things to eat. There are... No, Frankie. No what? You know what?
Mrs. Carson.
Miss Taylor, why did you move from Sydney to Melbourne?
I was living in Sydney with relatives. A friend in Melbourne offered me a place at her apartment and I accepted.
You stayed at the residence of Miss Frances Emily?
Yes.
From May last year until September?
Yes.
Did you then set up a residence of your own?
Yes.
Was this move to your own house precipitated by your desire to be intimate with Mr. Coleman in private?
No, that is totally untrue. I've been looking for a place of my own for months.
Do you know Mr. Rupert Wilson?
A businessman.
Of Sydney?
Yes. But I don't see what that...
What was your relationship with Mr. Wilson?
I was employed by him.
Your Honour, these questions are utterly irrelevant.
I shall be the judge of that, Mrs. Carson.
Did Mr. Wilson send you regular payments?
Yes.
Why did he make these arrangements?
When Mr. Wilson retired, he promised to continue paying me until I was settled.
I see. Do you still receive these payments?
No.
Why is that?
Mr. Wilson passed away.
When did he die?
May this year.
That is also when you instigated this action, is it not?
Around that time, yes.
Miss Taylor, is there any connection between the cessation of the payments from Sydney due to the death of your benefactor and the commencement of this present action?
Certainly not.
We shall see. In what capacity did Mr. Wilson employ you?
As a sales assistant in his jewelry shop.
As a jeweler, of course. And he employed you as an assistant.
Yes.
Not as his mistress?
Your Honour, I must protest.
He was a fine man. You have no right to defame him. What you are saying is totally untrue.
We both fell in love with the same man. It doesn't really seem so surprising now, does it? When that same man tried to kill you, I didn't lift a finger to help. Would your sister have done that?
Jilly, I have tried so hard to forgive you. I think I can now.
You shouldn't. I think I hated you from the moment you married Greg Marsden. Not because I wanted him to, but because once again, Stephanie Harper, poor little rich girl, walked off with the first prize.
And I want to change all that.
too late.
I don't suppose you got any books on basic writing, have you? For Emma. She doesn't know yet, but I don't teach her how to write.
Help yourself.
Anyone in particular?
You choose.
All those rodeo trophies?
Uh-huh.
How'd she get to be so good?
My whole family were rodeo people. We followed the circuit every year, so... Well, I guess I've had a head start.
Well, you must have seen most of Australia, then.
We did move around a lot.
One of the best collections I've ever seen. You read them all?
Oh, yes. Yes, of course. Well, I have to check on Jamie, if you'll excuse me. Is there anything else you need to know?
No.
Oh, God.
Can you get my license out of the glove box, please?
Do you see what happened?
Yeah.
You too?
Where?
I'll get your names and addresses in a moment, all right?
And you tuned that way, please. Thanks for joining us.
What are you doing here? They didn't give you the sack, did they?
No, I just had him in morning tea. Here.
What's this? It's not payday.
I got an advance. I knew you were broke.
You're too good to me, Angie.
Where's Nick?
He's out looking for a job. I think he's onto something, too.
What about you?
Angie, you know I'm trying.
I know, love. We just can't keep going on like this.
I'll fix it. Trust me.
Gonna tell him or not, Wynn?
Tell us what, Ron?
Well, I sort of reckon we've been talking about it long enough. We'll tell him, Wynn.
Well, Celine, it's just gone and proposed to me. We're gonna be married next month.
Oh, well, I knew there was something you were thinking of.
Well, hurry up and congratulate us so we can get on the party.
I mean, of course, everyone will say I'm too young and everything, but I don't care. I know what I want. Listen to him, would you? Let's face it, I have to be lucky not to get killed. Most of them get killed sooner or later. Six of his mates have gone down since October. In 3 months, and that's just in training. So that's another reason to get married straight away.
What about your mum, Winnie?
She'll think I'm stupid. She won't care, though. She'd just be glad to get rid of me.
What are you doing in there? We're dying of thirst.
All right, hang on. Oh, Jesus, idiot. Hey, do you know how many kids he wants?
No.
Six.
Oh,
I mean, can you imagine it? No, I reckon four is plenty. Two of each. Mm. No, we argued about it once. Do you know what he said?
No.
He said, "That's all right, I'll fix you. I'll just get you."
Oh, no.
You did. Well, I told you he's an idiot.
Who's an idiot?
Oh, no.
Oh, listen to her. What's so funny? You're supposed to be getting us some more beer.
Oh, come and have a dance with me again first.
Oh, what?
Don't talk back. Just move. Hey, Kitty. Listen, I know you don't want me to be here, but I just thought you'd like to know. See, I had a visit from Sergeant Pilot Lucas the day before yesterday. Day when Darwin copped it too. And he tells me about Ron and Billy. See, they pranked. Some flame and hopeless pair of sprogs in Never Ants and lose their bearings over the Yangtze and smash into Ron and Billy's Oxford. And Ron's dead. I just thought you'd like to know. Snap.
mistake. They won't believe me. I keep trying to tell them I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
Reception committee later. You found guilty of kidnapping and attempted murder. Is that correct?
I can't tell
answer
you.
Answer the question. Is that correct? You found guilty and sentenced to 10 years in prison.
Yes.
All right, Mrs. Dexter, I let you drag me in here. Now, would you kindly tell me what it is you want?
Yes, the same thing that I've wanted for days, the truth.
The truth?
Yes, my dear. You pushed your way into Michael's room, and my daughter unfortunately drew the wrong conclusions.
Did she now?
Yes, she did, but I didn't. And I want you to go to her and tell her what really happened.
I'll go to her if you like, but I'll tell her exactly what I have before. The truth is, Michael and I have known each other since childhood, and he has always loved me. Always.
That's rubbish, and you know it.
How dare you speak to me like that?
Elena?
Yes, Your Majesty.
You have been talking with Mrs. Dexter about my son. Now let's talk about your father.
What about him, Your Majesty?
He stands to make a fortune from the Coldrico investment in our country. You know, of course, that Mrs. Dexter is Coldrico.
Yes, Your Majesty, I know that.
So, if my son's wedding to her daughter falls through, he wouldn't approve. Your father has a foul temper. True, Elena?
Yes, Your Majesty.
So if you would like to avoid feeling the effects of that temper, I suggest you go upstairs and face Amanda Carrington and tell her the truth, the absolute truth. Now,